हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर नंबर 9, दैट इज डायरेक्ट एंड इनवर्स वेरिएशन ऑफ क्लास 8 मैथमेटिक्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी विल सी व्हाट इज डायरेक्ट वेरिएशन। इफ टू क्वांटिटीज आर रिलेटेड इन सच अ वे दैट एन इंक्रीज इन वन क्वांटिटी लीड्स टू अ करस्पॉन्डिंग इंक्रीज इन द अदर एंड वाइस वर्सा, देन दिस इज अ केस ऑफ डायरेक्ट वेरिएशन। हियर वन एग्जाम्पल इज गिवन हियर, एक्स एंड वाई। एक्स इज द क्वांटिटी ऑफ शुगर इन किलोग्राम्स एंड वाई बी द कॉस्ट इन रुपीज। नाउ यू कैन सी दिस 2 इज द क्वांटिटी ऑफ शुगर, 2 किलोग्राम, 3 किलोग्राम, 5 किलोग्राम, 7 किलोग्राम, 10 किलोग्राम। एंड दिस वाई एलिमेंट्स, वाई नंबर्स विच आर गिवन 40, 60, 100, 140, 200, दिस आर द कॉस्ट प्राइस ऑफ द शुगर। सो 2 किलोग्राम शुगर इट्स कॉस्ट इज 40, 3 किलोग्राम शुगर इट्स कॉस्ट इज 60। सो लाइकवाइज ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस, इफ वी विल इंक्रीज द नंबर ऑफ किलोग्राम ऑफ क्वांटिटी ऑफ शुगर, देन द कॉस्ट इज ऑल्सो इंक्रीज। सो ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ दिस कॉन्सेप्ट वी विल सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज नंबर 9.1। क्वेश्चन नंबर 1, इफ एक्स एंड वाई वेरी डायरेक्टली, complete the following tables and find the constant of variation. Now for the first we will see x and y. Okay, for 1, 2, and here it is given 5 and 10. Now you can see 1, 2 blank is given, and 4, then blank is given 6. So we can easily write here which number will come here, 3, then here 5, then here 7, then for we will check for the y, 5 10 15, then 20 25 30 35, and then 40. The answers are also given here. Now for the second x, there you can see this is here it is given 8 and here it is given 16, and we know 8 to the it is 16. So 8 to the 16, 10 to the 20, 15 to the 13. So here in the blank there will be 15, then 21 to the 42. So 42 will be the answer here. 25 to the 50. So 25 will be the answer here. 28 to the, that is 56. So 56 will be here. Then 31 to the 62, so 31 will be the answer here, and 35 to the 70, so 70 will be the answer here. Now likewise you have to solve the next three question. Now question number 2, Meena bought 16 notebooks for rupees 360, find the cost of 24 notebooks. Now Meena bought 16 notebooks at cost rupees 360. Now first we will find out the Meena bought one notebook, what is the price of one notebook. So we have to divide it by the 16. So 360 divided by 16, the answer will be 22.5. this will is the price of one notebook. Now we have to find out the cost of 24 notebooks. So we have to multiply 24 into 22.5. it means the answer will be rupees 540. Now question number 3, for rupees 82.50 110 envelopes can be purchased, how many envelopes can be bought for rupees 75? Now 110 envelopes for rupees 82.50. now one envelope, we have to find out the price of one envelope. It means 110 divided by 82.5, it means 1.333 is the price of a single envelope. Now we have to find out how many envelopes can be bought for 75 rupees. So we have to multiply 1.333 multiply 75. So when you will multiply, you will get 100. It means for the 75 rupees we can purchase 100 envelopes. Now question number 4, the thickness of a pile containing 25 sheets is 1.5 centimeter. What is the thickness of a pile containing 85 sheets? So the thickness of pile containing 25 sheets is 1.5 centimeter. Now we have to find out the thickness of one sheet. So we have to divide 1.5 divided by 25, and also we have to find the
thickness of pile containing 85 sheets. So we have to multiply by 85, and now you have to solve this. When you will solve, you will get 5.1 centimeter. That will be the thickness of pile containing 85 sheets. Now question number 5. The taxi fare for 210 kilometer is rupees 1575. What would be the fare for 350 kilometer at the same rate? So let the fare for 1 kilometer be x. So 210 multiply x equals to 1575. It means we have to divide and we have to find out the value of x. This will be the fare for 1 kilometer, that is 7.5 rupees. Now we have to find out for 350 kilometers. So we have to multiply 350 into 7.5. It means rupees 2625 will be the answer. Now for the question number 6, in the same manner you have to solve. You have to find out the value of x and then you have to multiply with the number. Then you can easily find out how much will he earn. Now question number 7. Radhika types 270 words in 15 minutes. How many words would she type in 40 minutes? So 16 into x we considered the words, let the words typed in 1 second be x. So x into 16 equals to 270. So we have to divide 270 divided by 15. Here it will, here there will be 15. Now when you will divide the 18, we got the answer. The 18 word per minute is the speed. Now word typed by her in 40 minutes. So we have to multiply 40 multiply 18. So 72 words she can type in the 40 minutes. Now question number 8. If a van travels 44 kilometers on 5.5 liters of petrol, how far will it travel on 16 liters of petrol? So let the distance traveled by van in 1 liter petrol be x. So 5.5 multiply x equals to 44. X divided by x equals to 44 divided by 5.5. So x, the value of x we got is 8 kilometer. Now again we have to multiply 8 into 16. We have to find out for the 16 liters. So we have to multiply 8 into 16. The answer will be 128 kilometer. This much a van can travel on 16 liters of petrol. Now question number 9. If 36 meters of cloth cost rupees 918, how much meters of the same cloth can be purchased for rupees 255? So let the cost of 1 meter cloth be x. So 36 multiply x equals to 918. So we have to divide 918 by 36. Now the value of the cost of 1 meter of cloth will be 25.5. So we have to find out for 255 rupees how many meter we can purchase. So 255 divided by 25.5, it means 10 meter we can purchased for rupees 255. Now question number 10. The railway fare for a journey of 240 kilometer is rupees 1344. What would be the fare for a 500 kilometer long journey? So let the fare for 1 kilometer be x. So 240 multiply x equals to 1344. So x equals to, we have to divide 1344 by 24. So 5.6, this will be the fare for 1 kilometer. Now we have to find out the fare for 500 kilometers. So we have to multiply 500 multiply 5.6. It means rupees 2800 will be the answer. Now on the same manner you have to solve question number 11. Now question number 12. On a bookshelf in the library, 140 copies of a book occupy 11.9 meter of space. How much space will 212 copies of the same book occupy? Now let the space occupied by one book be x. So 1.9 divided by 140. So x, the value of x is 0.085. Now you have to multiply by 2.212 multiply by
0.085 to find out the space will 212 copies of the same book occupy. Now question number 13. A tree 15 meter in height cast a shadow of 9 meter. Find the height of a tree that will cast a shadow of 15 meter under similar condition. So the shadow of 1 meter tree be x. So 15 multiply x equals to 9. So x equals to 9 by 15. So when you will divide, you will get the value in decimal, that is 0.6 meter. Now let the height of the tree that will cast a shadow of 15 be h. So here we have considered the h. So h multiply x equals to 15. So h multiply 0.6 equals to 15. So h equals to 25. When you will solve this, you will get 25 meters. So the height of tree will be 25 meter. Now question number 14. An electric pole 18 meter high cast a shadow of 10 meter. What would be the length of the shadow of a pole 14.4 meter high under similar condition? So 18 into x equals to 10, then 10 divided by 18, it means now again we have to find out the shadow cast by 14.4 meter high pole will be. So 14.4 multiplied by x, now we will put the value of x, that is 10 by 18, it means 8 meter. Now question number 15. The weight of 17 boxes is 603.5 kilogram. Find the weight of 22 similar boxes. So let the weight of one box be x. So weight of 17 box will be 17x. So 17x equals to 603.5. Now you have to divide these quantities, 603.5 divided by 17. So x equals to 35.5. This will be the value of weight of one box. Now we have to find out the weight of 22 similar boxes. So weight of 22 boxes will be, so 22x, it means 22 multiply this value, that is 35.5. so 22 multiplied 35.5, when you will multiply, you will get the value 781. So the weight of 22 boxes is 781 kilogram. Here we have completed till question number 15. Now in the next video we will start from question number 16. Till that you have to practice all these 15 questions very well. Thank you and have a nice day.